Good evening.
Mi brama.
It's wonderful to be here tonight.
Pasa me gusta que tiene tan brama.
God is so good, isn't he?
Hasta el día que va a peor.
And it's good to sing to the Lord.
Es muy bonito cantar con él.
We prepare the atmosphere and the place.
Me preparamos la atmósfera, el ambiente.
Through singing.
Para mis cantos.
Through praising.
Lo que la adoro.
This is a way that we open our hearts.
Lo que nos une a Dios en la toma.
We minister to Him.
Y sabemos a ti.
And then God ministers back to us. And I want Him to minister tonight to you.
Me gusta que se vea tú, ¿verdad? Que le gusta.
God gave me a message tonight.
Me dio un buen mensaje para ti.
So He wants to speak through me to you.
I don't just ask that to be a mail. Thank you.
I want to go before the Lord in prayer and ask Him.
Does we have a part of this in the book here that you're going to?
To give us guidance right now.
To now listen up and going.
That He can say exactly through me what He wants to say.
Try to talk to Mama. Never be a mail. I don't try to go to talk.
Father, I thank you for this opportunity to come here to Albania to minister your word to every person that is here. And I pray, Father, that by the power of the Holy Spirit that you bring forth your word in a way that every person here can understand. I pray that you love your word into the hearts of each person, that they would know that you are a loving God, that you are a good God, that you are a Father God. I pray, Holy Spirit, you move in a mighty way, that you confirm the word with signs and wonders. We release your power right now, Holy Spirit, to move in this place and to confirm Father's word tonight. Jesus, we say, you are Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, I want to talk about how important you are to God. How valuable you are. How precious you are. The Bible says in 1 John 4 and verse 16 that God is love. God doesn't have love. He is love. He doesn't just have love. But literally, He is love. That's God. When you think of God, you can think of love. When you think of love, you can think of God. I like the name of Pastor Elton's church. And there's a reason that he named this church with this name. Because somewhere in his life, he got a revelation of who God is. He got a revelation that God is love. That's what the word agape means. It's talking about the love of God. Well, the Bible says that God created man in His likeness and in His image. Now think about it. If you are love, and you don't have anything like yourself to manifest that love to, then what would be the best thing for you to do? The best thing would be to create something like yourself to manifest
cristiană lui cântăm, ci ești mult a manifestat și cântăm în lui.
And this is why God made man.
Pentru că el o inimiu.
You're not a monkey.
Tu nu ești mai mult.
You're not an insect.
Nu ești insect.
You're not a tree.
Apoi e bim.
Those things have life. They were created by God. But they were not created in His image. God created man in His image, in His likeness, to manifest Himself, His love too. And so you were created by love, God, for love, to be loved by God. Oh, tell your neighbor, you are very important. You were the apple of God's eye. That's the reason for your existence. God created you so that He can manifest His love to you. Well, there's also a devil out there. And he doesn't want man to be loved. He doesn't want man to be loved by God. He doesn't want man to have relationship with love. And so he does everything he can to stop that love from flowing into man's life the way it's supposed to. He'll provide all kinds of substitutes. Man walks around in this world and they do this and they do all these kind of things, and what are they looking for? What they're really looking for is love. And one of the greatest scriptures that we have in the
Bible
is John, the third chapter, in verse
16.
And this scripture changed my life when I was 7 years old. I'll never forget. I saw a picture one time of Jesus. And he was hanging on a cross. And I was a child and I thought, wow, what's that about? And then I saw another picture of Jesus knocking on a door. And I thought, what is that about? And then somebody came along into my life and they shared this scripture from the Bible, John 3 and verse 16, that says, for God, who is God? Everybody say, God is love. So for love, so loved the world, or for God so loved the world that He gave. Love is a giver. It's not a taker, it's a giver. Love wants to give. Love wants to bless. Love wants the object that it wants to love to have good things. So for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him believes in Jesus. And that's where I found out, wow, Jesus died on the cross because of love. There was a reason for that. Jesus never sinned. He was a perfect man. He was God that came down in a body. But yet He died a terrible death. He died the worst death that a criminal could die when Jesus died on the cross, did a very bad thing. But I found out that the reason he went there was because he had this nature in him. This love nature that wanted to give something. It wanted to take away something. And it wanted to give something. And what it wanted to take away was all the bad stuff. And what it wanted to give was the good stuff. Oh, yesterday as I was flying here. And you know, any time that I go out and travel, I say, God, send me across the right people's paths at the right time. For divine appointments. I don't want to just go places. But I want to talk to the right people at the right time. And I want to do what God does through people. And so yesterday, I had a little bit of detour in my airplane flight. And I ended up in Vienna at a later time. And there were five Albanians that were sitting around getting ready to come. They had left England and they were coming here. And this guy saw me at the coffee bar and I was ordering something to drink. And he said, hey, come over here. I thought, wow. I think we got a divine appointment. And I went over there. And they started asking me. And they found out I was a Christian. They said, wow, we've been talking about religion all day. And I thought, hallelujah. And there's a lady that was sitting there. And she said, sir, and they found out I was a minister. Do you think that God is a good God? I said, oh yes, ma'am. Do you think God wants us to have a good life? I said, oh yes, ma'am. I think God is a good God, and I think He wants to have us to have a good life. She said, oh wow. And I thought, you know what? This lady has a complete different picture of God because of the religions that are in the world. He's not a bad God. He's a good God. He's a loving God. And as a good God and as a loving God, He wants man to have a good life. And this life that God wants man to have, it begins because through accepting what Jesus did out of love on this cross. This love came out of the earth through God coming in a body. It lived a perfect life. And it showed man what it means to look like in the earth as a man, as a son that has relationship with a God, as a father. Oh, come on. That's wonderful. When you look at Jesus and the way He lived, He didn't live like people in this world live. That live away from God. He lived knowing God as a loving Father. And He lived knowing that He was a Son. that was loved by a father.
And
then Jesus said,
Jesus,
as my father has loved me, even so I love you. And so everywhere that Jesus went, for the 3 years of ministry, he went around loving people, saying good things to those that would receive, telling people that they were forgiven, setting people free that had demons on the inside, healing the sick, opening the blind eyes, showing man that God loves man. And then Jesus died on this cross. Why did he do that? Why did he die such a terrible death? Because Jesus had to take away something that was separating man from having a love relationship with the love God Father. Oh, I have good news for you tonight. You are worth something to God. You are important to God. You are so important to God that God would come from heaven to the earth. He would show you what it looks like to have a relationship with him as a son or a daughter in his family. And then he would go to a cross and he would die. Why? Because of man's condition of sin. You see, a loving God cannot be one with a sinful man. And when God created this first man that he created for love, this man disobeyed God. He ate of a tree. And this tree was full of a sinful nature. And when man ate of this tree, and you say, oh, why did a loving God put a bad tree there? Well, one issue was that God wanted man to make a choice. You can either choose the bad tree or you can choose me. That's one reason. There are other reasons, but I don't have time to get into that tonight. There's a much deeper reason. But man ate of that tree, and when he did, he brought a sin nature in him. And the Bible tells us when he did that, instead of man having confidence in God's presence, he was afraid. He hid himself. He was naked. He was ashamed.
She said,
there was guilt on the inside of him. There was fear on the inside of him. He didn't have confidence. And because of that, he brought a curse into the earth. And he brought bad things into his life. And the Bible tells us that because Adam did that, he took this world that God had given Adam to rule over, and he turned it over to the devil. And what happened? The devil brought bad things into this earth. God did not create you to be sick. God did not create you to be poor. God did not create you to be separated from him.
înapoi
with sin. God wants to be one with you. He wants to have a relationship with you. You see, you understand that when God created you, yes, He created you to be loved. God created you as a three-part being. And this is what the Bible teaches. The Bible teaches that we are a spirit. Everybody say, I'm a spirit. You are a spirit. That's the eternal part of you. And then you have a soul. This is your mind. Your will. Your emotions. And then you live in a body. This body is your house in this earth. Well, God is a spirit. And God wants to be one with you. He wants to be one with you in the spirit. He doesn't want you to be separated from
Him.
He wants to have spiritual relationship with you as a son or a daughter. Oh, that'll make you do what my brother said. It'll make you
shout.
This is where the joy comes. Because you see, in the love of God, there is joy. In the love of God, there is peace. In the love of God, there is goodness. In the love of God, there's healing. Healing in the love of God. All the goodness of God is there. Is that powerful? And so when Jesus died, what did He do? If you died on a cross at that time, the Bible tells us in the book of Galatians, it says that anyone that died upon a cross was considered cursed. It's like somebody that goes to prison for a long time. The cross was literally the death penalty for the worst criminals. And so when Jesus died on that cross, do you know what happened to Him? He took all the bad stuff into Himself. Jesus said, I have the power to lay my life down. He laid His good life down. And He hung on the cross. And Jesus cried out on the cross, my God, my God, why have You left me? Why have You turned Your back on me? Why have You walked away from me? Before the cross, Jesus talked with God, His Father. He was regularly talking with Him. He was regularly asking Him, Father, what do You want me to do today? Speak to me. Speak through me. Work through me. And we see God working through Jesus, bringing the goodness of God over and over and over. But then they nailed Him on the cross. And Jesus hung there. And He said, my God! My God! Jesus was there on the cross representing you. In your sinful condition. He was there representing Adam. And all of the bad things that He did. He was there representing the entire world. that has disobeyed, has sinned, and has a sin nature in them.
Și kishin natură căpătare, ce ești în acum cu tine.
You see, we got this sin nature because the first man did a bad thing.
Și ne kimi când natură ne kishin să ce ai din un mar bun păcat.
And this is why we have all the different religions in the world. Man is trying to get rid of this sin, feeling this guilt.
Pare sunt, pare că mi-ești fiert tot pentru dușmanul meu Bob. Ce ești în mundul ăsta cu natura mea ca
ești. He's trying to find God in his own way. He's trying to satisfy the inside. That is separated from God. But here's the thing. No good works can get rid of this. Because people work and they work and they work so hard. I'm a good person. But on the inside, they say it like that. I'm a good person. But even though they're, I'm a good person, there's something on the inside. I'm really not. Because outside of knowing Jesus Christ, you have a sin nature in your spirit. And you as a man cannot live a perfect life. There's only one. There's only one. There's only one person that has ever come to this world that lived a perfect, sinless life. The Bible says that Jesus was tempted in all different ways. He was tempted with all different, he had all kinds of opportunities to disobey God. It was a temptation. Just like Adam and Eve, they were tempted. And they said yes to the temptation. But Jesus said no. And the next day of temptation would come, and Jesus said no. And the next day of temptation would come, and Jesus would say no. He was a perfect man that lived a perfect life. Oh, that's good news for you and I. Because when Jesus hung on the cross, he did not hang there because of any bad thing he had done.
Wow!
So why did he go there? Because that was the place where God made him. The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians
5:21.
For God made. God made him. Jesus. To be sin. God made Jesus to be sin. Well, where did he get the sin? Look at your neighbor and say, he got it from you. He got it from you. He got it from you.
I am going with
you. He got it from you.
I am going with
you. He got it from you.
I am going with
you. He got it from you.
I am going with
you. He got it from you.
I am going with
you. He got it from you. He got it from me. Preacher Mark.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
He got it from all of us.
I'm going to get there.
He hung there and bam!
I should do it here.
All the sin of the world. From that time all the way back to Old Testament. The entire human race nature of sin was put in the Son of God at the cross.
Wow.
That's how important you are. That's how important I am. That's how important the human race is to God. And here you say, yeah, but this is all these people. I'm just a little tiny people and a bunch of millions. No, the Bible says that Jesus is the last Adam, which means that he actually died for the first Adam. And this tells us if there was only one person in the world, they were that important to God. So I'm telling you something. You are important. Look at your neighbor and say, you are important. You are important. Albania is important. Every person out there on that street is important. Hallelujah! You know, I was petting a dog today. And this man was right there by the dog. And there was something moving in his face. And so we got to talk to him. Because here's the thing about the love of God. It moves in your heart, and everybody you come in contact with, you're important. This man waited on us in the restaurant today. And we told him, you're important. We gave him a tip. Because we wanted him to know he was important. We told his boss. We said, we're going to pray for this restaurant. For the blessing of God to be on the restaurant. Why? Because they're important. All the people we come in contact with are important. Oh, somebody shout in this place tonight. Hallelujah. It says, for as much as you know, you are not redeemed with corruptible things. The Bible tells us that we were redeemed, or we were not redeemed, with corruptible things as silver and gold, from our vain conversation received by tradition from the fathers. But verse 19, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. Now, in this Bible verse, we have a word redeemed. And I don't know what the Albanian word is. But I want to tell you a Greek word. Everybody say Greek. There's a special Greek word for this word redeemed. It's the Greek word lutro. And he knows a little Greek, so maybe he can pronounce it the right way if I'm not. You know it? Okay. I want to explain this. This word, when there were people that were slaves during this time, you know what a slave is. And if you were somebody that had slaves working for you, you would go into a place and where they sold slaves. And you would look at these slaves. And you know, if you were a buyer, you would go and you'd say, I want to see all the slaves, the people that are going to be sold to be slaves. And so you looked at the people. And there were times that they would even beat the slaves. Because they wanted to see if these slaves could endure a beating. You would open their mouths. And you would see if their teeth were good. You know, like going and buying a car and you say, hey, I want to drive the car. And so you would do this. And then they had the time where all the slave buyers would come and they would bid on the slaves. And the person that was offering the slave, they would keep raising the price up, And they would do everything they could to get the most money out of the slave. You understand that? Well, this word, lutro, has a different meaning. And this is where we come to the end of the message. And this is where we come to the love of God. And this is where we come to how important you are. The Bible tells us that we were bought with something that was more valuable than silver, that was more valuable than gold. Silver is the highest value of the precious, and gold is the highest value of the precious metals. But think about this. You're more important than gold. The price for you was higher than gold, higher than silver. Oh, tell your neighbor you're important. People go buy brand new cars and hey, cool.
And this is going to be like even an old.
But 30 years later, hey, not so cool. Because all these things eventually wear out. But the Bible says that you were bought with the blood. And the blood represents Jesus giving his life. Taking the sin. He was made sin. With our sin. In 2 Corinthians 5:21, that we might be made. The righteousness. Oh, the righteousness.
Amen.
Does anybody know what it means to be made righteous? That means that we have sinned. We came into this world. We sinned. We were separated from God. We couldn't have relationship with God. If you're here tonight and you've never accepted Jesus, you don't have relationship with God. But I'm telling you something. I have tonight what you're looking for. I have a way for you to be loved like you've never been loved before. Hallelujah. For you to know God, not just God way out there, but personally. Like that woman at the airport. She said, well, I don't know if he... I said, yes, ma'am, he's a good guy. I said, I talk to him all the time. I said, in fact, I talked to him as I was walking over here. She said, you did? I said, yes, I know him. I know him personally. He's my father. Oh, come on. Hallelujah. Amen. He's my father. So, that we might be made the righteousness of God.
Wow.
Through Jesus, He made a way that all the sin believe you. Oh my goodness, that is good. You can live in this world without any sin. Has this preacher gone nuts tonight? Remember, you are a spirit. You have a soul. And you live in a body. And in order for God to have relationship with you as one, He has to change your spirit. And this is what happened when Jesus was on the cross. He took the sin that was in our spirit. He took the sin that was in our spirit. He took that in Himself. Wow! This is why He said, God, why'd you leave me? Because God could have no relationship with Him at that time. God is righteous. But because we were in Jesus in His death, we were in Jesus at His resurrection. That's powerful. So when you accept Jesus, that He did the work for you, that He shed His blood for you, and His blood represents Him laying His life down, and then taking it back again, when you accept Jesus, you know what you accept? God's righteousness. Wow. And in the spirit, all the sin nature that separates you from a loving God leaves. And you become a brand new person. Is that powerful? And you can have the same relationship with God as Father that Jesus had. You are born again. Now, this word redeemed, this is what it means. There are some people that bought slaves, and they would take them home and work them hard and work them hard and work them hard. But there were other people that had love for these slaves. And you know what they would do? They would go to the places where these slaves were sold, and they would pay whatever it took to buy that slave. And then you know what they would do? They would set the slave free. Can you imagine being a slave? And somebody's buying you, and you're spending all kinds.
fie liber.
You're free.
Fie liber.
And not only are you free,
eu nu te fie liber,
but I treat you as a son.
Unde mai doi tu sunt liber.
And not only that, here's your inheritance.
Dar tu vei atras de mine.
Woo! You're a son, not a slave.
Ei, tu ești slav, nu ești liber.
This is what Jesus did.
Era Jesus in glory.
He came. He gave his life, which was much higher than you ever
owed. It's not high as
you
think.
He bought you out of slavery.
So he has left my mommy.
No longer a slave to the devil.
No más malo to diablos.
But a brand new life.
Cuando yo entré
in Jesus Christ,
in Jesus Christ,
as a son,
si dear,
as a daughter.
See,
that's how important you are to God.
I can see some fear.
Jesus paid for you.
Jesus is my point.
And set you free.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, church. That's the good news.
I stand in here.
That's the good news.
I stand in here.
Tonight, I want to give you an opportunity. I'm
going
to pray for you tonight. There may be people here
can you do
that need healing in their bodies. I'm
going
to pray for you tonight. Because that's another thing that Jesus paid for. When Jesus paid for the sin, he paid for the sickness. And I will pray for you. And you will receive healing in your body. Before you receive healing, there's something that's even more important than that. And I ask you, do you know for sure God in a personal way? Do you know God as a father? Do you know God in the same way that Jesus did? You can tonight. You can be loved. You can go through this life knowing that he loves you. You can go through this life and he will speak to you. His love will begin to manifest to you like you never experienced before. You say, preacher, you don't know what I've done. That's why Jesus died. You can't pay for it. You can't do enough good. Only Jesus. And so tonight, do you want to know a loving God? Do you want to know heaven as your future? There is a hell. And that's why Jesus went there. Because hell was the penalty for that sin. When people don't accept Jesus, then they end up holding on, let's say this pulpit would be like sin. And they end up holding on to the sin. And so they die. And when they die, they held on to the sin. And so they end up going and paying for what they did. They end up in the penalty. And Jesus, he paid it. Church, he paid it. Sinner, person, he paid it. You don't have to be in that condition anymore. God will change you from being a sinner to a son of God. He will make you righteous. He will fill you with himself, with his love, and you will have a relationship with him that is different than anything else, any other relationship you ever had. You will be born again, which means God gives you a brand new life. Born into his family. Do you know tonight? I want everybody to close their eyes, and the Holy Spirit is moving right now. And he's showing you how much God loves you. He's showing you your condition of sin. And he's showing you to examine.
Dua që ta
I want you to look at your life.
Duke parë vetëm tënde.
I want you to look. You've been looking and looking.
Ma ta shqetësh vetëm tënde. Duke parë vetëm tënde.
You don't have to look anymore.
S'ke nevojë të shikosh.
Jesus is the answer.
Sa të Jezusi është përgjigjja.
And it's very simple.
Shumë e thjeshtë.
If you don't know, everybody with their eyes closed, because I want everybody to focus on themselves right now. Are you ready to meet God? If you were to die tonight, and I'm not saying you're going to die tonight, but if you were, would you be ready? Are you ready for the next life? You're a spirit person. You'll never forget this night. Because this is your opportunity. To be one with God and God to be one with you. And you will get love. What you've been looking for in all the different ways. Do you want this life tonight? If you don't have this life with God in a personal way, lift your hand
and I'll pray.
There's one. Anybody else? You want this brand new life tonight? Brand new. Who has problems in their right knee tonight? Somebody here, you got a lot of pain in your knee. I want to pray for you. I'm going to pray for you when I get done. This man here, he raised his hand. Anybody else, you want to know God in a personal way tonight? This is a chance. I mean, this is the biggest gift. There's no other bigger gift than what I give you tonight. Jesus will change your life. Anybody here? Anybody else? Hallelujah. Uplifted hand, you say, that's me. I want to pray and receive Jesus tonight. Thank you, Lord. All right, we're going to pray with you, sir, tonight. It's so simple. So simple. Everybody pray with me as we pray with this guy. God, I come to you. And everybody else you can pray with in those
prayers.
I believe in you, Jesus. Jesus, I believe that you died for me. You died on the cross because I was important. And you took my sin.
On
the cross. And I want to thank you. And Jesus, you went to hell. Jesus, you went to hell. Pay for my sin. And I thank you.
Don't find
the Lord.
And Jesus, you raised from the dead. And I believe that. God, you're my Father. And I believe that. Jesus, you're my Lord, my Savior.
Jesus te exulti, mas te exultarei.
Jesus te exulti, mas te exultarei.
Hello, brother.
Presidente,
you're in the family God.
A gente está com família sempre.
You just prayed the most important prayer.
Que agora não que é bom não se isso não tem que ir
para lá. Eu amo muito a camisa de Deus. Eu amo muito. Eu tenho vida.
So good, isn't he, church? everybody that needs to be healed
tonight.
I'd like to pray for you. We have a lot of people that get healed. Is there anybody having back problems? You? Can I pray for you? I told you I would. You want to stand up?
I'm sorry.